Hey everyone, and welcome to Tabletop Obscura presenting Outlaws of Alkenstar.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hello. Someone would rather be playing grounded.
Maybe.
Also, thank you, Osiris, for the bits. I do appreciate it.
Oh my god, is Osiris in chat? I have no idea who that is.
Yeah, we have no idea who that is.
I've never met an Osiris in my life.
But we do appreciate it, Osiris1138.
Yes, we do.
I really shouldn't bully people in chat, though. That feels like a mean thing to do for the streamer.
That's why I was doing it for you, Matt.
I appreciate it. Sharing the load. That's a GM tip for you. Share the load of GMing with your players.
And everything. Let them bully random people.
Right? Isn't that what moderators are for? But! How is everyone?
I am doing well. I finally managed to talk to my boss and go, so I'm not working 20 hours a week and doing school. So that's nice.
So you're doing 40 hours a week and school?
No, I'm doing, I think next week I'm doing like 4 hours because they scheduled me for one day.
Oh, fun.
Which, like, I don't mind, but yeah. It is hilarious how quickly they'll shift between extremes.
Capitalism for ya. Now, double checking. Yes, all the graphics are good. Awesome. So, Nick, what have you been up to this week?
Working.
Working?
Yep. That's really the long and short of what I do. Listen, man, if I ever do anything interesting, you will be the first to know.
Oh, no, look, I get it. I truly do.
How was your week, Matt?
How was my week? Busy, to put it lightly. Just working on the stuff for Sinclair's library.
Yeah. Aren't you always?
Well, yeah, they pay me.
Yeah, that's your job. You nerd.
Right? A big nerd working in the tabletop role-playing game industry? Jeez.
Yeah.
But no, I also spent $3,000 in like 10 minutes, so that was fun.
Oh, that sounds fun.
What did you do?
On the bright side, I'll be seeing if anyone listening to this is going to PAX Unplugged in Philadelphia this year. I will see you there.
Oh, that would do it. Plane tickets are expensive.
Traveling.
Yeah. Thankfully, accommodations are already being handled, but...
I was like, dang, Matt spent a lot of money on something, and then you revealed it was travel, and I was like, oh, fair, honestly. That was probably a good deal.
Apparently it was a little bit above average. Or it was like,
bummer.
In like the yellow range for plane tickets, it was like dead center.
Hmm.
So it wasn't extraordinarily cheap or extraordinarily expensive, but the travel agent explained to me, so you're flying between Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fair.
So, I'll take it. An accommodation's already been handled.
Yeah, that's nice.
I believe Sinclair's is paying for the tickets for me to enter as well.
Nice.
I can dig it.
Because you're a content creator for them.
Genuinely thought you were going to say communist.
Well.
Well, I wasn't gonna talk about Matt's political affiliations on stream. I'm a poli-sci major, but I don't talk about it that much.
But no, they are apparently they're going to be providing me with a shirt and hoodie to wear as well, so that'll be fun.
Oh, fun. I can't wait to see Matt in his government-assigned outfit.
God, I hope not. But, Sam, what have you been up to?
fixing Ian's character sheet.
Well, that's actually a little bit of a good segue. Ian will be with us. He will be running a little bit late, as is my prerequisite whenever there's a daylight savings time switch. This is me going, basically saying daylight savings time is fucking bullshit, and I don't know why anyone does it still. But because
tradition.
Of that...
So that I don't go home in darkness, so I have time in the afternoon to look at the pretty sunset.
Think about the pretty sunset, Matt.
Fuck the pretty sunset. I have the internet. Mind you, I can't talk. I have a window in my bedroom, and I have literally blocked it off with bookcases. So.
That seems like a fire hazard. Is that within code?
Code?
Where do you put
building
stuff inside
codes?
Your house?
What do you mean, where do I put stuff inside my building?
It's a house.
It is a house.
So houses still need to be up to fire codes.
Yeah, when you build it. Any liabilities on the is on the residents after that.
Wild. You guys don't have people come that, like, can theoretically go into your house and enforce fire code?
No, I'm pretty sure insurance companies can come along and make recommendations and change premiums.
We have a guy who comes by every year, I think, and does have fire alarms, but that's about it.
Oh, wild.
Yeah, no, it is actually pretty crazy. But, otherwise, quick update. Things with Sinclair's Library is going well. We are working on the first public playtest to go out, but it's a case of everything is currently going into edits, and there's a lot to edit. Oh shit, there's a lot to edit.
What, were too many people trying to use the word schlorp?
That's gonna be a fun villain entry to write.
The schlorpifier?
No, just schlorp, the ooze.
I love him.
It's gonna be a sentient ooze.
Clearly, I should just buy Sinclair's when it releases, just for that. Schlorp the ooze.
Well, there'll be a lot more things for Sinclair's than just Schlop the Ooze. There'll be two new ancestries, two new classes, more than, I think the count is over 20 new archetypes and subclasses for pretty much all the classes before Dark Archive. So we don't have anything in there for the Psychic or the Formatage.
Formatage.
Okay, there we go. We all know that I can't pronounce shit.
Really? I thought you did quite well just there.
Well, why thank you. But, I think that's about it for announcements and things.
Probably.
One last thing. Thank you to everyone who is listening to this on the VOD. Because of you, the VODs are actually doing really well on YouTube. Really fucking well, considering what we're doing here. And considering, all the other fun stuff. But we're regularly hitting over 10 views in 24 hours on YouTube, which is pretty spectacular for YouTube actual play content like this.
I mean, I don't know. I Critical Role gets...
I haven't watched them since the start of their third season.
First rule of tabletop actual plays is we don't compare ourselves to Critical Role.
Oh, I know.
That way lies danger.
Why would
I just was making a funny joke, Matt.
Oh, I know. And it was kind of funny.
It's like comparing a professional architect's building to someone who likes to draw houses. And then asking people to build them and seeing the results.
You do okay.
That could be a fun little thing. Like a fun little event.
Funnily enough, professionals are professionals because they're professionals.
Well, yes. And it is always important to remind everyone that everyone involved in Critical Role are professional voice actors.
They are, and they're good at their jobs.
They're exceedingly good at their jobs.
They are.
Yeah, Travis Willingham from Mario, for fuck's sake.
He's already Superman, it's fine.
Okay, then we what, just pick someone like, else.
You don't like Chris Pratt for Mario?
No.
I do not.
They could have just used the existing voice actor. Right?
They could have. They absolutely could have. But they didn't. Because apparently this is going to be a celebrity movie driven by celebrities, I guess. But I don't know.
That's capitalism for you. That's
Matt
market.
Mercer's a celebrity. They could have had him as Mario.
His glorious hair is a celebrity. I'll tell you that much.
I hear it's insured in Japan for $10,000.
That's iconic.
Actually, yes. Laura Bailey for Mario. I think she'd do a better job than Chris Pratt.
He is amazing.
I think Laura Bailey would do a great job as Mario.
Right. We'll just get the Critical Role crew to just dub over all the vocal parts.
And both Sam and Liam for Luigi.
Both of them working together?
Uh-huh. Yeah, so when Mario has to do his big monologue, we'll get Liam O'Brien to do it. And then when it's doing like the funny jump voices and things, we'll get Sam Riegel to do it. Actually, nice. Interchangeably would be good. But Jack Black is Bowser. Perfect. Don't change the thing. Okay, yeah, no, that would be good. Just Sam or Liam for Luigi.
Yeah.
Just don't iconic. Know which one. But who remembers what happened last week?
Girls' Day.
Girls' Day.
That's what I remember, Matt.
Girls' Day happened and nothing else. It was a spa day. And everyone had a good time and no violence was had by anyone.
We were off the clock, Matt. No matter how much you wanted to put us on the clock.
It was strictly down to skill checks and you did fine.
I casted a spell, Matt.
You did, and you did well. And they failed their will save. But I think it would have been funny if you had a fight in the bathhouse. You would have gotten like a permanent ban or something.
No, Matt. I can't get a permanent ban from the only nice place in this godforsaken hellhole of a town.
Now, look, Alkenstar has some great places.
They're all just on the place where I'm not allowed to go legally.
Well, you're the one who rocked up with a magical disguise.
How was I supposed to know that standard law enforcement had anti-magic fields in this town?
To be fair,
you always just try not breaking the law.
Well, she didn't know it'd be breaking the law.
Outlaws.
We are literally an outlaws of Alkenstar, okay?
I don't. Yeah, it's need just this a suggestion propaganda. To go against the grain.
ACAB.
Yeah, no ACAB. But after successfully rescuing Vashon Gattleby from the Yeast of Old Brewery, our heroes started to, well, they were told to lay low for a couple of days, but decided to instead start the investigations into other things.
The only person thus far that's been capable of laying low is Hinkle. And the only okay. reason he does that is because his hobbies involve laying low.
We laid low.
Yeah, no, you did. You absolutely did.
We only told two people our names. Do you know how much of an achievement that is for us?
Don't go outside, Impossible Edition.
It's boring inside. Only boring people stay inside.
You had a puzzle that you could have done, but you decided to shoot it.
And now the puzzle is done.
And you've lost all the nice things that you could have won.
Yeah.
Not gonna lie, I kinda wish I knew what was in there.
Nope, we're not allowed to.
I don't even think he told me what was in there.
I don't think he told himself what was in there.
Oh no, he did. He gave me a list.
He sent it via chat, and I'm pretty sure I pinned the message.
Oh, well.
But it doesn't matter now, does it?
No.
Because you blew it apart. But yes, no. There was a girls' day where you went to the Lady of the Lake bathhouse. And you got to meet some Powderkeg punks who told you some stuff. Yeah. Question is, do you remember what they told you?
Yeah.
Yeah, they told us. Well, definitely my character does. I would say Matt. And I'm pretty sure there was something about they had a really hard day because they had to be on patrol all night, yada yada yada.
Because someone showed up, a bunch of their other gang members.
Oh, right, yeah.
And they're trying to look for the people who did that.
Means it's probably not us, because then they would have said shot and banged up.
See, I see where you're going with that. Still. But you are doing further investigations to the Powderkeg punks. You're pretty sure you know who's hired them, being the shield marshals and Lovelace herself. But you're also trying to find out where the headquarters are located so you can get them to fucking stop. You do, however, have a couple of days of downtime where you can do a little bit of investigation before Phoebe would like you to start shooting bullets at people. Just so the shield marshals can, not be hounding her for everything. And Tinkle, you've been doing really well with that.
Yeah. Oh, could you please add the formula for the explosive stuff to my book?
The explosive stuff?
Yeah, his recipe for his super explosive alchemist fire.
Oh, the pyronite?
Yeah, that one.
Okay, so for pyronite, are you gonna actually ask for Gattleby's help with putting down the formula?
Didn't he literally give us the recipe?
Yeah, but it's in his own handwriting.
Yeah, I'll
in his own shorthand and stuff.
I'll just be copying it across.
All right, I need the crafting check from you then.
Okay. The crafting check. That's a crafting
Shouldn't
check.
Shouldn't this be society to decipher writing?
20, I think they'll actually do it.
Yay!
Because Gattleby's not going to stonewall you on it. You did do him a fucking solid.
I'm not even planning to throw it. Can I tell you what I'm planning to do with it?
Don't think so.
Ooh.
You're not going to share?
No, because it'll involve creating another recipe.
Now I'm concerned.
Rocket launcher?
No, bomb launcher already exists.
Yeah.
Cheap and affordable warm heating for the elderly?
I definitely told you.
That's not right.
No, it's far more interesting.
I've gotten too deep into this character.
I love Fragile.
I don't remember a goddamn thing. Awesome.
I mean, Porkchop did your massage. That was nice.
Alright. I'm going to lose 38 GP.
Oh, that's so many GP.
Yep. But I get cool things as a result of it.
Ooh, what cool things do you get?
Recipes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, that makes more
recipes.
Sense.
Because recipes are, for some reason...
Recipes are pretty expensive. And I will find the pyronite for you later, because the one that I have is level 11, and you can't make that.
Oh, it's level 11? Okay, I'm not planning on making the actual thing, but...
For the terms of the story, you do have the recipe for pyronite.
You just disappear, or did I do it?
Reese's Pieces? Yeah. Eat 'em up, eat 'em up, eat 'em up.
wild.
But what else are you doing, Hinkle?
I go shopping for other recipes. And a... and I get to work trying to craft a pepper box.
Alright. Well, give me a Diplomacy Society check for the recipes.
Girls!
If you're looking for a store where you can buy some stuff.
That's my Socrates check.
Did you want to reload it? Well, no, reload does kind of work. Reroll it.
Do you want to reload your dice? Probably. It seems like a little early, so no.
All right.
I don't think I spent any any of my checks last time.
Well, after making a few inquiries around Smokeside, eventually it gets to the point where the places that sell recipes kind of are a little bit more suspicious than you would like. The Ferris Tinker works are good, but particularly when it comes to alchemy, they don't do nearly as much. They're more into like doing mechanical stuff, and they're also pretty guarded about their recipes. However, after a couple of hours of inquiring and wondering, you are informed about Rika's reagents.
Connection lost.
Oh, fun. But it's good, because you know the recording's still going. But, slight disconnection. Let's see if we come back.
One.
Are we coming back?
Connected.
We're back? It's a 1x3. That's what you need. Hello.
Hello.
Congratulations, Mo.
Hi. What? Hello.
That's
connecting
better.
To chat.
You're a little fuzzy, but mostly good.
A little bit fuzzy, but mostly.
My good. Internet's always stable, says Matt.
I haven't had an issue in literally months. And now it's like, yeah, no, we're going to start screwing with you now. We're in the chat room. Hey, chat, am I back?
Hi, chat.
I don't see Tabletop Obscura yet. He's offline still.
Oh, wild.
Matt, if you don't keep talking, I'm going to assume you dropped in.
Technical difficulties.
Da, 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 da. Matt's a 23-month subscriber to his channel. Nice.
I am?
Nice.
Holy shit.
Sorry.
Oh, I can smell fried chicken downstairs and it's making me hungry.
Oh dear god. Okay, people are starting to come back.
Yay!
Hey, chat, can you hear me?
Yeah, a little bit.
Looks like we're crunchy, but back.
Maybe I should just put Foundry onto my other computer.
I don't think me disconnecting is your fault, Sam.
No, but it'd mean the rest of us wouldn't disconnect.
Oh, switching over to Forge. Like I said, this is the first time I've had issues with this in months. But...
it's true.
Sam.
Me.
When did I drop out?
You spend some time.
You spend some time searching and looking around the city. And unfortunately, for the most part, most of the alchemy places on this side of the river are dubious, to say the least. And to say the most of them, they're pretty guarded with their recipes. Even the Ferris Tinkerworks, who are known for being pretty inventive and pretty open, are more inclined to share technical devices than anything to do with alchemy. But you do eventually hear about a place called Rika's Reagents. Or have I dropped out again?
Connection lost.
For fuck's sake!
Welcome to the channel.
Connected.
I'll be honest, I have no idea where the 3x1 went. I just replaced it with 3 studs. So.
That's not how that works.
A 3x1 and 3 studs? It's yeah, a 3x1 thin.
Yeah, but they give you those that 3x1 for a specific reason, and those 3 studs you could use need to be used for something else.
Oh, which no, there are 3 studs that are spares from another set. Talking about Star Wars.
Star Wars and stuff.
Don't talk about your Lego anymore. Ugh.
What's wrong with Lego?
She's not following the instructions.
I'm sorry that they didn't give me a 3x1.
No, they did.
I
you just
do.
Lost it.
I did not.
If you haven't got the 3x1, then that means you're the problem.
Okay.
I have never lost a single piece.
I've never lost a single piece.
We make do, okay?
So, Rika's Reagents is the shop that you've been told to go to, Hinkle.
I heard that one.
Okay.
Something Reagents.
Rika's Reagents.
Oh my god.
Praetor Rikard's Reagents. Got it.
Rika's Reagents.
Got it. Yeah, that one. No, don't tell me he's gone again.
No, I'm still here.
Sam, okay.
What?
I'm blaming Sam for this. You keep trying to give him something and then dying.
I'm just suggesting
it's
he goes to a
fault.
Fucking store.
I just want to make use of the system that I couldn't last time I played the game. Agents of Edgewatch didn't let me craft, and I just want to do it.
No, look, I do understand, and I do
Riker's
appreciate it.
Reagents.
So, entering the small shop on the other side of Blythe College, it is run by Riker herself. Who is a very nice Tengu lady. And she greets you as you enter. Oh, hello. Oh, no, I'm gone again.
I you're in and out frequently.
Fucking much.
I can't make... I'm just going to disconnect from Foundry so that you can maintain somewhat of a semblance of a connection. So it stops trying to ping me back to you, which I am sure is causing you to have issues.
Yeah.
I'm currently on backup internet, so. The equivalent of 4G.
Oh yeah, I should probably get a 5G good. Chip.
4G, 5G. Either way, we don't have a great connection here.
I'm sounding better.
I'm sounding better?
May I make a recommendation to you two as well to not deck to Foundry so that Matt has one less thing to try and reconnect to each time he drops?
I'm not connected to Foundry because it takes me about, 5 minutes to connect every single time.
Yeah.
And so I just don't until Matt has a stable connection when he starts going in and out.
We're gonna do this old school.
Theater of the mind?
Something to that effect. But hey, look, I'm still recording, so I'm still gonna continue.
That's the spirit.
Because, you know, at the very least, the YouTube VOD can be uncut and it can be fine. We'll have a bit of a gobble for when I stepped away from the microphone to yell at the internet. But, as I said, she introduces herself. What can I help you with?
I'd like some recipes.
Recipes? What kind?
Yeah, petition, fire, ice, lightning bottles, pesh pine grenades, ein Tanglefoot bug, and Drakeheart mutagens, bitte schön.
Oh, so, things of a more martial and defensive nature, then.
Yeah.
Well, we could certainly manage that for you. I am afraid if you are after the ingredients, however, I'm currently out.
Oh, this is fine. I will be able to...
Sam, could you give me a diplomacy check if I haven't dropped out? I think I've dropped out. How fun is this? Don't you just love it?
Connection lost.
Yep, there we go. So, we're currently having storms here in Newcastle, and apparently they might be screwing with the internet a little bit. We're not 100% sure why. I may eventually just have to reset the modem and hope for the best. But, until they come back...
It's very cool. Stable internet connection with Matt.
It honestly is. It'd be so cool.
It would be so cool if I could just have a guaranteed connection at all fucking times.
Maybe you should just go stream grounded instead.
Become a gaming channel.
Oh, look, I don't think it would do much better at the moment. Not for streaming, anyway. Because I think the connection to Twitch is going in and out. Very chunky, at any rate.
Yes. Yes, it
to is. To put it mildly, very chunky. So...
No.
She can arrange those recipes for you, Hinkle.
Yay!
Yay! Oh wow, the closed captions are having a field day as well. Oof. But otherwise, she says, yes, we've been having troubles with ingredients of late.
Got it. Ingredient troubles. That's okay. I can go find them elsewhere. Or make them myself.
Dang. Side quest rejected.
Reject all side quests.
I'm busy crafting. Someone else has to get me the goods.
Gonna make me do it? Just be like, Ariel, you still owe me for the armor. Go get me cool stuff.
I think you literally do owe me money for the armor.
I do owe you money for the armor.
But that's alright. I have all the money.
I think I owe you like 8 gold pieces, which I simply do not have, so...
That's okay. I have money that I probably should have distributed to others, but haven't yet.
That's okay. But... you finish up at Riker's reagents after getting your recipes. And she finishes off by saying, well, I hope you have a nice day. With any
luck... Thank you very much.
With any luck, you'll do whatever it is you're planning.
Explosions. Lots of them. Everywhere.
Oh, God,
Pyronite fires all the time. Those arsonist people will love me.
Nothing like the love of a Powderkeg punk.
Yeah.
But... who wants to go next? If Hinkle's going to be doing things with recipes and things like that.
He will certainly try. Oh, I need to buy a fucking pepper box recipe.
That you can get from the Tinkerworks pretty easily.
Neat.
You'd think they'd be more secretive about their patents.
Well, things like pepper boxes and flintlocks aren't really...
They're because we do live in Alkenstar.
Yeah.
Yep.
If you're in somewhere like Absalom or... hell, even Grund or the Expanse, it'd be a lot harder to get a hold of these kind of recipes. But you're in Alkenstar.
The City of Smoke.
Yep. Alkenstar, City of Smog.
Yuck.
Now, you knew that Tonk was out somewhere doing some investigations and looking into some things. However much he's looking into, however, you're not sure as he hasn't returned.
Understood.
But, Ariel and Fragile...
are a slide pistol.
You'll be coming back from your spa day. Being all fresh and pampered.
Does this mean I get a item bonus to diplomacy checks, Matt?
For people who care about that kind of thing, yes.
Awesome.
You will get a +1 item bonus.
Hell yeah.
Or if you already have an item bonus from somewhere else, you can call it a circumstance bonus instead.
I don't have an item bonus to diplomacy for things.
Yet. Am I benevolent or fucking what?
Unsure. Depends on how many villain points you get.
Well, I mean, currently.
Hey, Bill. We're back. Chat's working again.
Hello, friends.
Internet's being pretty chunky for me at the moment, unfortunately, for some reason. I fucking hate it. But it's okay. This is why I record and stream at the same time. So I can just upload the recorded VOD and people can hear me complain about the internet for like 10 minutes. Which, you know, content. Hashtag.
Yay, hashtag, hashtag.
What was that?
But, Ariel and Fragile.
Me.
Yay.
Back at the Bullet and Barrel Saloon, what do you want to do to investigate the Powderkeg punks? You got some information from the ones that you met in the bathhouse.
but do either of you remember what it was actually, what they actually said?
My character definitely remembers, Matt.
My character definitely does not.
When fiction imitates art?
One of us always speaks the truth, one of us always lies.
We just have a tendency to forget which one is which. What? But, Ariel.
Yeah.
You were informed that they were supposed to be meeting up with their boss of some sort, or their leader, at a place called the Longhorn Lounge.
Okay.
Now, if you want to know more information about that, I will need a society check or a city lore check.
Yeah, I would definitely roll that for you if I was in the foundry, Matt.
That's very true. Which would you prefer, and I will roll it for you?
Lore city, because it's probably going to have the easier DC.
I'm going to try. If Matt dies, blame it on me this time.
I've already connected.
Blame it on Sam.
He's stable so far.
The light is green. Like, the little OBS square is green. Would you like to re-roll that, Ariel?
Did I roll?
He got an 8.
An 8 total? Yeah. Why
re-roll?
Not? It's the first bad roll of the session. When would be a better time to use my hero point?
There you go. 15. Much better.
Let's go. And this is with a specific lore check.
It is. So the DC does get dropped a little bit. So, you have a bit of a think about it, and you know of the Longhorn Lounge as a location for, well, rodeo performers?
Yeah.
Rodeo?
Yes.
Hey, you pronounced it wrong.
I have to pronounce something wrong every session, otherwise I explode.
Pretty sure Rodeo is pretty good.
It's pronounced rodeo, at least, you know, where it actually happens.
Yeah, it happens in Australia.
Yeah.
We have rodeos. Rodeos.
And we have proper words here. No, rodeos. I like you saying rodeos. Please continue to do that.
I'll just use the two interchangeably.
Have rodeos with the rodeo clones.
Oh my god.
This is my first rodeo. Rodeo.
Lots of horses.
We'll go to Scone to get a scone.
No, I don't like that. I don't like you for doing that. Please stop.
Ooh, I'm in.
But yes, the Longhorn Lounge caters to that kind of activity. Well, more to the point, people who have either retired or are currently performing. It's a great place for talent scouts, for instance, if they're trying to organize races or performances and things to that like.
Neat.
You know, they have a pretty upper crust dress code.
Well, good thing I have a hat of disguise, Matt.
Also, good thing that you've been at a bathhouse all day.
Yeah, and I look very fancy. I would buy fine clothes, but again, I am broke.
Sounds like a you issue.
It is a me issue. It is, in fact, a me issue. But, I suppose I would... I mean, if they're just, like, it's just sort of a day visit, yeah, I'll go for a day visit to see what's going down with the powder keggers. Sort of do some reconnaissance.
Like I said, you've spent the day at the bathhouse, got massages and everything else like that. So it'd be afternoon, evening at this point. So, that will work out pretty well for a club or a bar.
But I'll head in.
Fragile, what are you going to do?
So it's the evening sort of time?
Get in there. It's not nighttime quite yet, but...
Well, I'll go find those cops.
God damn it.
Which ones?
The cute ones.
The cute ones that helped me through the market that one time.
Oh, okay.
Pretty sure they were on evening shift.
To a degree, yeah.
I am, in fact, their boss, or so they think.
Well, I'm pretty sure you don't have Lore City, so I'm going to say Society check or Diplomacy check.
Do I have?
Take your pick in that matter.
I have Lore Scouting. That's probably not the same thing.
Scouting.
That's Lore. It's a Lore Scouting, so I know about Scouting. I don't know how to scout.
I mean, that would be a survival skill then.
Yeah. Diplomacy it is. Oh, that was so close.
So close to what?
Nat 20.
I mean, still a success, and that's pretty on par for you. But yes, you will eventually find the shield marshals. Good. You're pretty sure you knew where they were. They were kind of in the markets, just a bit of the ways beyond the bridge. And eventually, you do find them. And the younger one kind of gives you a wave.
I'd like run over to them. Oh. I'm hoping they give me compliments.
Howdy, ma'am. You're looking awful nice today.
I know. Smelling pretty, too. Lovely spa. I don't remember its name, but it's super nice.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I can tell you. Looks like you've been for a bit of a pampering. What can we do for you today, ma'am? Time. Wait, you're inviting us?
Yeah, sure, why not?
I cannot wait for that.
I mean, we don't make too much money. The other one kind of nudges him a little, and we probably shouldn't be fraternizing with the civilians too much, especially on the clock. So what can we do for you, ma'am?
I just thought I'd come over and say hi. You two are my favorite cops, after all.
I mean, technically we're shield marshals. We're not, like, police officers. But
that's,
I guess...
such a mouthful, though.
I mean, you can call us cops if you like. If one gives him a dirty look.
Law enforcement officers.
But, so you just came by to say hi?
Yeah, do you guys know my friends, Jonesy and Ruby? They're from the punks. They're punks. How cool is that?
The Powderkeg punks?
Yeah, that one.
Okay, they're your friends. Are you a Powderkeg punk?
Maybe? No, I'm not cool enough to join
okay,
the Powderkeg.
Okay, that's good. Well...
Wait, what? Why do you think that's good? Do you not think I'm cool enough? He starts tearing up.
Ma'am. No, look. We think you're gosh damn pretty enough to be anything that you want to be.
Aw, thanks.
But we're kind of glad you're not a powder keg punk, because we're currently on the lookout for him and, you know, to do a little bit of arresting.
Oh, why?
Because they've been blowing random shit up around the neighborhood. And there was a disturbance at the bridge last night.
Larceny, and farceny.
Was there?
That was only last night? Wild. I thought we'd been laying low for longer.
Is everyone okay?
There were a few casualties there, and the body washed up on the far side of the river, but otherwise...
Oh, that's terrible.
Some pretty massive contusions as well. Someone's considering they might have gotten hit by a boat or an anchor or something.
Hmm. Hey, so... Listen, so... Why am I, like, doing this? Do I have a point?
Is this Fragile asking, or is this Nick?
This is Nick. I thought we got where we were supposed to go last time.
You're looking for the Powderkeg punks, or at least where they're currently housed. Ariel has a lead, and she's following up on it.
Oh, cool. Hey, do you know where the Powderkeg punks are or currently housed?
Give me a diplomacy check.
You got it, bud. Do I get, like, any bonuses because of how good I look?
Plus one. Because, yeah. You know, you spent the day at the buff house pampering yourself. So I'll give you the plus one.
One, add, roll the dice.
Looks bitchin'. Love it. So, he kind of thinks about it for a couple of moments, and he's like, well, I'm not supposed to be telling the civilians, but you're going to be keeping away from the place, ain't you?
Oh, sure. I never go looking for trouble.
The other one kind of just narrows his eyes a little bit.
I blow him a little kiss.
There is a slight couple of moments where his stern demeanor cracks a little bit. But if I was to make a suggestion to you, ma'am, if you're trying to stay out of trouble, you might want to stay away from the Hotfoot Hippodrome.
The Hotfoot Hippo...
The Drome.
The...
It's a dance club, ma'am.
The Hypnodome.
Hypno toad?
A hot foot hippodrome.
Hop to hippo moan.
No, no, no. The hot foot hippodrome.
So, wait, why am I not going there?
Because that's where they are. Well, we think they're there. We have a suspicion that they run the place. It's a dance slash music club where they do all sorts of experimental musics and stuff. Lots of goblin metal, as far as I'm aware.
Goblin metal?
Goblins aren't made of metal. You can't trick me. I'm too smart.
I love Fragile.
Oh god, Shredder and Krang. God, no.
What? Master Shredder!
Yeah, no, no, goblins aren't made of metal. But, you know, some goblins wear metal. And some goblins use metal to play music.
They do. You are so right. Wow.
Well, thank you, ma'am. I try to be right whenever I can. And I try to look out the citizens for whenever I can as well.
So where is this hypnobome?
The hippodrome? Is that what you're after?
Here.
Oh, God. Now, like I said, you should probably avoid it as much as you can, right?
Well, I can't avoid it if I don't know where it is.
Well, you
what
just...
What if I accidentally got there, and they had metal goblins everywhere?
I mean, you do have a point there, ma'am.
I know a guy. And he is really good at things that are metal. One of my best friends is a robot.
You have a best
I hope
friend
she's
who's...
not talking about Heinrich.
Ma'am, are you talking like an automator?
I don't know what he does for a living, but, like, he fights real good, so he might be an automator.
Okay. Well, you just stay away from the Ironside Quarter, yeah?
What is the Ironside Quarter?
It's that walled-in section of the city not far from here. Still technically part of the city, but that's where the Hippodrome is.
Why do I feel like Fragile thinks Automator is some sort of ironic device?
Automator PETA.
No,
Automator Philia.
It's Mater, if you got, like, the
if it was an auto instead of a manual. No. No.
I don't know. Okay.
Get out, Matt.
But no, I would avoid it if you could. It's a rough place, man, and we wouldn't want your pretty visage getting messed up at all.
Oh god, no, I spent like 2 gold on this.
We could tell.
Yeah, I think it was worth every penny equivalent.
Silver?
Copper? I don't fucking know. I'm not from around here.
Well, where are you from, ma'am?
Oh, I travel a lot. I used to live in a circus. The Circus of Wayward Wonders. That's where my parents live. They're carnies.
Oh, okay.
But I'm a mercenary. I was really good, but now someone owes me a big apology.
Oh, okay. Well, I hope you find that someone and they give you the apology you very muchly deserve. But
you guys know where, like, some smoothies could be had? Or boba tea? Oh, do you have boba tea here?
Boba tea?
Yeah.
I mean, Happy I think Noka. There might be somewhere around here. I don't know for sure. I mostly just hit the coffee.
Where's some good coffee? Where can we go for coffee?
He points out a nice little coffee cup.
Fragile gets in between the two of them and, like, wraps an arm around each of one of their arms, and it's just like, okay, so you guys are taking me out for coffee. That's cool. Let's go get coffee! And maybe, like, some tiny cakes!
How about we get a diplomacy check for me first?
Oh, come on. I'm gonna win.
Are you, though?
I haven't spent my hero point yet. Yes.
Now you are.
About to spend my hero point. Jesus Christ. Come on, hubris.
Evidence.jpg?
Let's fix this up, maybe? Shall we?
That's about right. The one who's been talking to you looks to his more silent friend and kind of like, we can take 5 minutes. You know, we're not going far. We're still on patrol.
That sounds like cops.
He's doing he's patrolling the rounds, that's for sure.
The other one shakes their head and just kind of gives a shrug and is like, yeah, see, no, we're good. Yeah, let's go grab a coffee.
You can tell me more about this Nippopome.
Hippodrome.
Hypno-gnome.
Hypno-gnome.
Hippodrome, as things kind of fade to black and you can take them over to the coffee cart. Ariel!
Yeah. I'm horsing around.
You're horsing around? Well, you will make your way up to the Longhorn Lounge. I don't regret the gift module, but it's definitely a thing right now.
Oh, I forgot about gifts. I search something fairly inconspicuous and it gets some pretty sus results.
Yeah, no, I remember last week.
So a misclick could end poorly.
But
mm-hmm.
You end up at the Longhorn Lounge, and despite the clientele that they mostly cater to, it's a nice looking place.
Okay.
Even for Skyside, it kind of stands out as a nice-looking bar.
Oh, I'm on Skyside?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Okay. I would have not been in magical disguise before crossing the bridge, because I just know afterwards. That now.
Yeah, no, yeah. That's fair.
I would have taken some time to do, like, a mundane disguise. So, I still wouldn't have looked like, you know, wanted fugitive, but...
Well,
yeah.
Like I said before, you've spent the day in a spa getting yourself all perfumed and pretty, so you'll be fine in that regard.
Okay. I will head across, and I will probably see what's going down over here.
Well, there's a little bit of a lineup to get inside. It's a good dozen or so people.
As you approach, however, with your general standing and countenance, and the fact that you have the dandy archetype.
Yeah.
Because it specifically calls out if they have the dandy dedication, they don't have to do the skill checks.
Oh, that's so cool.
If any member of the party has the dandy dedication archetype feat, their sheer command of etiquette is enough for them to talk their way past the door guards.
That's wow. So cool.
Neat.
Ow.
I love that they call that out.
How have I never taken that?
Because you always go for the no hit points approach.
Oh, yeah.
The bouncers for the bar kind of call you to the front, Ariel.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What can we do for you today, ma'am?
Yes, I was wondering if I could possibly, have watch the show, as it were. Would that not, I'm aware I didn't, have a reservation, but, you know, things just happen so fast, and one day your friends are like, oh, we can definitely all hang out for a girls' day. And then they've canceled, and you're left all alone for the evening. And I'll throw in a little wink on that part.
Well, the bouncer continues and he says, well, we can't have that now, can we? And I believe you would be a beautiful addition to the clientele of our dear establishment tonight. And he picks up, he unclips the red rope and allows you to pass.
Yeah, let's go.
No cover charge either.
Let's go. When I get in, I would like to find what looks like the powder keg punks. I'm in disguise, obviously.
Yep.
Cause I talked to them the other day. like earlier today. So, I would obviously be in disguise, but I will look sort of around for them.
Yep, that's fair enough. Give me a perception check.
Yeah, perception.
That's pretty obvious. You don't have to roll this one secret, because we're...
Okay.
This is not intended to be a combat encounter.
Awesome. 20. Dirty.
Having a quick look around, you don't actually see any of the powder keg punks. More to the point... Looking around the place, you're seeing a lot of suits and evening wear. Like, it kind of gives off a football club vibe. Like, there's a lot of big guys who are 6 foot something, and they've managed to squeeze themselves into suits.
Iconic, but, honestly.
But they're not security. It's like a sports bar, but an upper class one.
Okay, okay. It looks very much like powder keg punks would not be around here.
Yeah, it's a little bit too upscale for them.
Wild. And I don't see Ruby and whomever my other friend was.
Jonesy? You do not.
Hmm. That is interesting. Very, very interesting. Yeah, I will.
Yep.
Is there anyone else who might look suspicious, shady? A little, sort of more towards the fringe of society, as it were.
From your perception check,
you discover a mirror.
Harsh. You do not actually find anyone who looks suspicious or out of the way. There is a bartender, however.
Perception check, Matt.
It wasn't that hard. There are events that are currently ongoing.
Yeah, then I will sort of hang around.
Hang around for a little bit?
Yeah, hang around for a bit.
Eventually,
I'm in no hurry. I'm enjoying the high society, as it were.
Eventually a waiter will come up and go, ma'am, would you like a drink? Or perhaps a seat?
Yes, I would like, a seat, sort of, and I will find a seat nearest the cutest person at the around, who seems to be sitting alone, with my 20 perception, whom I would have found. And, I would request to be seated near them.
They kind of have a look around, and they go, "We'll see what we can do for you, ma'am. Would you like a drink while you're waiting?"
Yes. Matt, I would definitely know what drinks I can afford with my 14 silver pieces.
That's a glass of wine. Two silver pieces for a glass of wine.
Okay, two silver pieces for a glass of wine.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're not, like, hitting the bottle yet. The full bottle, anyway.
Okay, I will... Yeah, I've removed it. I will get a glass of wine.
Oh, good. He takes you to a seat at the bar. And he goes, "As soon as we have a table available for you, we'll get you there."
All right. And I will continue to sort of calmly, looking as if just nothing is wrong, be searching constantly to see if I see any of the punks or anyone who might look like they're doing something untoward.
Alright. Give me another perception check, then.
Yeah, I will roll you another perception check, Matt. Let us see what we will get with my pretty bad perception.
Pretty bad
Even
perception.
Better.
Pretty bad perception, huh?
Okay, all I'm saying is that, like, champions have pretty bad perception. Because they don't get it well, like, a sort of by proficiency, and they don't invest in wisdom.
Which seems weird to me, but I guess they use charisma more.
Yeah.
Well, having a look around, one of the things that strikes you as odd is the bouncers are focusing on any of the shorter people who are coming in.
Okay.
So if it's a halfling, a gnome, or a goblin, they're searching them for, like, firearms and explosives and everything else like that. Whereas the taller folk are being pretty much allowed in with nothing but a cursory glance.
Wild.
It does strike you as a little bit bit odd. And the bartender kind of comes up to you, seeing that you're taking a little bit of interest, and he goes, "Yeah, we're not too happy about it either, but after the last couple of nights, it's turned out to be what we need to do."
I'm sorry, I've been a little preoccupied over the past couple of days. What happened?
Well, we had an incident of a gang leader coming in here to visit one of our members.
Oh my god, that's ghastly.
They pretty
I
much showed up in
I completely forgotten to do my accent this time, by the way. I apologize to all of the people who wanted my accent. I just remembered. I will be doing it from this point on. Hey, that's ghastly.
I thought you were doing an in-character bit, because, you know, you're disguising and stuff.
Nope.
You could have not said a single damn thing, and no one would have noticed or said a thing.
Well, I realized, and I was like, oh, shucks.
Anyway. We had... showed up in armor with this big honking weapon on his shoulder as well, and we had to remove him from the bar pretty quickly, but there was a bit of a scuffle about the whole thing.
Hey, well, I certainly hope that doesn't happen again, because that would be a terrible way to have your evening. So, obviously, this was the Powderkeg's punks member trying to get a meeting with someone. I I would like to discreetly inquire as to who they were trying to get an audience with.
And what do you say to do your discreet inquiry?
I will,
Please.
Have the feet, Matt. Isn't that good enough for you?
No, no. I know you have the feet. I've got it in mind. I still want you to say something, though.
Yeah.
You know how this works.
I know, Matt.
This ain't your first rodeo.
God damn it. You wouldn't happen to, happen to know who that was, because, you know, I frankly, you know, one of my friends has been going out with this really rough-looking customer who does try to frequent some of the nicer places where we go, but he really doesn't fit in, so I was just wondering, is that what the patron was like that they were trying to see, or... Because I wouldn't want my friend going out with a potential gangbanger.
All right. Diplomacy or deception? It is your choice.
Ooh, deception, then. Oof. And I've already used my hero point.
Does chat want to help you out a bit? No? Maybe not? No? Okay.
I mean, a 15 isn't awful. It's just bad for me.
It is kind of bad for you. It's like, sorry, I wouldn't know. I wasn't really working that night.
I'll keep it in mind.
You can ask around with some of the other staff members, though.
Yeah, I absolutely will do that. Discreetly, with my feet. Discreet inquiry.
From your dandy dedication?
No, I think it's just a skill feat that I took.
Yeah, no,
for
I think
being expert
well.
In deception, which I got from my dandy, but... So, yeah. That is what I will be doing for... Unless something else happens the rest of the evening, probably.
Yeah, there, we'll see how your check goes.
Do you want me to roll another, probably, diplomacy check?
Yeah, it'll be diplomacy now, because you're gathering information.
Yep.
Still discreet inquiry, so no one's going to really make a fuss about it.
Yep. Oh, God.
Oh, wow, okay.
I'm rolling so badly tonight, apparently, when it comes to my diplomacy check.
Where's Fragile when you need her?
Oh, Fragile doesn't know the meaning of discreet.
No, so... that is very true.
Literally.
Eventually, a table is freed up near one of the nicer-looking bachelors.
Yeah! The real goal of why we went out on the town tonight.
Oh, yeah.
You are told that he is from your discreet inquiries, you are told that he's a rodeo star.
Oh, so the guy I'm sitting with is a rodeo star, but not the guy they were trying to meet. I don't know anything about.
No, you have not been successful enough, unfortunately. But you do. It's an adjacent table. You're not sitting with him.
Mm-hmm.
But it's close enough that you're able to kind of give the wink, maybe order a drink for him. Discreetly kind of make your way over to him, if you would so like.
Yeah, Matt, bold of you to assume I have the money to be ordering drinks from people. I wanted people to be ordering drinks for me.
Well, what are you going to do to grab that kind of attention?
Be super hot, for one, Matt.
Just be super hot? See, this is where I would love Anima's style skill, where it's just like, I'm gonna roll style. Let's see what happens. I fucking love that skill.
And I'll sort of be subtly flirting with him, sort of throwing him a wink, throwing him a smile, a giggle, as it were. Well, do you want me to roll diplomacy, Matt?
Diplomacy or deception?
Ooh, deception's better.
Do you have to roll a perception check to understand flirtation?
20.
Well, it'd be against his perception DC, wouldn't it? He kind of, he sees you smiling and, you know, doing the giggle, and he does the whole gesturing to himself.
I absolutely nod.
He, asks for one of the waiters to come over, and there's a short exchange of words, and the waiter comes over to you and goes, Mr. O'Shea would like you, like to know if you would like the pleasure of his company for this evening.
What an honor. I would absolutely love to spend some time with the famed rodeo star. How famed is he, Matt? How believable is that? Who knows?
Give me a society check.
Yeah, give me that society. I'm an expert in this. I'm an expert.
As the GM hurriedly puts together her notes. Kyle O'Shea, he is known as a pretty big rodeo star, wrestling bull and cow and bison, and also other creatures that are being tamed and brought in from the waste themselves. In Alkenstar itself, rodeo is, it's usual as we would expect from our world, where, you know, you ride around on a bull for as long as possible, but considering this is Galarian, and considering the geography in which you find yourself in, it's not unusual for them to bring in bigger and uglier creatures just to create a little bit more of a spectacle.
Mm-hmm.
Kyle O'Shea has been known to ride and wrestle down an aggravated Triceratops.
That's pretty cool. What, do they just import them from the Isle of Cordus?
Sometimes, yeah.
Wild. That's where the dinosaurs are, right?
Isle of Cordus, yes.
Yeah.
Typically, they're also in the Mwangi Expanse to some extent, but they're a little bit more protected there than Cordus.
Okay. Cool, 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 cool. Well, I will walk over to his table and sit down.
You take your seat and he goes, well, howdy, ma'am. I wasn't expecting someone of your visage to be gracing the Longhorn Lambs this evening.
It's not too forward to say, you've got quite a visage yourself.
Oh, wow, yeah. Thank you. Just, my manager insists that I get seen in these monkey suits. It's not my usual attire, I can assure you.
I've heard of what you do at those rodeos, as they say. A Triceratops, aren't you ever a little bit scared?
Oh, look, ma'am, it's always a little bit frightening. It's always a case of stage fright. I'll tell you what, I'm more scared of the people in the audience than I am of any of the critters that I fight.
Hey, well, that's very brave of you.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah.
The most vicious of creatures out there are people, I can tell you that much.
Hey, that's the truth, ain't it?
I have my fair share of scars from all manner of hoof and horn, but I can tell you what, the thing that hurts the most is a bullet wound.
I've never had to experience one of those myself, but I hear that they're not very pleasant. You want me to roll deception for that, Matt?
Yes.
I have been shot.
Several times in the back.
Yeah. 17.
At least you haven't had your chest exploded yet.
That is very true.
several times in the back while not wearing armor.
Well, I don't know about that, ma'am. I mean, as beautiful as you are currently looking, I do know a woman who's been through the wars herself.
Ex-military,
or?
I've done my time in the servant, in the, as a sort of blade for hire, although that term, I hate to use it now for myself, but, you know, as a young woman, I had to do what I had to do, although I'm not too old, am I?
He kind of smiles and goes, no, ma'am, you're looking quite good for your age. What are you, like, 21, 22?
If that. Yeah, thereabouts. do I have a canonical age for her? 25. She's 25.
You're also an Asimar, so.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, how old are you? I don't know. Can you put an age on pretty? But he continues and kind of rolls down the sleeve for his suit jacket after unbuttoning it slightly. Mm-hmm. And you can see the rather thick signs of a bandage. It's been done, and they're hiding it well, but...
what happened there?
Oh, so if you would believe it, a couple of nights back... In this very bar, there was a bit of a kerfuffle with someone from the, smoke side of town. And the bouncers were having a little bit of trouble escadating him, so I decided to step in myself. And this is what I got from my troubles.
That sounds terrible. Is there... did you recognize this fella? Like, was he, I don't know. I hear those Powderkeg punks have been getting even bolder, despite our brave Shield Marshal's best efforts.
I didn't know that at the time, but apparently, he was the boss or something for him.
Hey. You know, they keep getting bolder every day. They'll be storming the bridges.
Oh. Boy, I hope not. Because, like I said... I can handle bulls, I can handle dinosaurs, but, you know, line me up in front of a bunch of people with guns and, no, that show just ain't for me. But I did some discreet inquiries and my manager made sure to remove the gentleman they were looking for off the membership rolls.
Hey, well, I'm glad because that just sounds absolutely terrifying. Ugh. What was this gentleman they were looking for like? I mean, it'd be hard to imagine one of these fine people at this establishment, hanging around with one of them.
Well, give me a diplomacy check.
Yeah. Give you a talking skill.
You are doing a lot of talking.
I know, Matt. Oh my god.
For fuck's sake.
I get a plus one to that. It's a 13.
A 13?
Yeah, because I forgot to add my item bonus.
Well, he continues and says, well, I don't roughly remember his name.
Note that was discreet, though, Matt.
Yeah, no. I'm well aware of your discreet inquiries. I could probably find out for you, but I know he's some sort of alchemist.
I'll just file that away. I know, it's not important. What's more important, he's you right here tonight, and I sort of softly take his hand.
Aww. He blushes.
Romance.
He blushes like a tomato in spring.
Matt.
Yep.
I really want to be nice and heal his bullet wound. How suspicious would that be? What check do I need to make to know how suspicious that would be?
Oh, I want to say society.
Okay, I can roll it.
Is this where you roll well? Yeah, no, this is where you roll well. Look, with the magical abilities of healing in Galarian itself, having a little bit of minor healing ability is not that unusual.
Alright, yeah, and I can always just pass it off as my angel heritage. Yeah. I will throw a little lay on hands on this fella. I think I would have refocused talking to him, so I'll have two. Because I think flirting constitutes as refocusing as of Arshay. And
you know what? He'll
heal 12.
Oh, wow. Well, his damage was mostly peripheral at this point, but
yeah.
As you take his hand and he kind of starts blushing, he does feel that warm glow kind of go over him. And he gives his arm a little bit of a stretch and goes, oh, wow, that pain's all gone.
If there's one thing to thank my angelic heritage for, it's that little bit of healing that it gave me.
Well, pain's definitely gone. What's your name? I'll have to tell my manager about you, see whether you can be there for my next match.
I will, my name is, we're gonna come up with a fake name.
Fragile.
Ariel Smithfield. Fuck.
No. My name is, Adeline, Farmhand. My father came from a line of farmers, but apparently he hit it big when he found some gold in the field. Or my grandfather did, actually. So, need a deception check for me.
Yeah,
Matt.
That was almost a 3.
That's what I roll good on. The worst name ever.
I've heard worse. Well, Miss Farmhand.
I need to put that in my notes because I will not remember it.
Will absolutely, and this will come up again. We have a named NPC now.
What is his name while I'm putting it things in notes? Also, where do I take notes on this character sheet?
There should be a book icon in the top right-hand corner.
Oh, biography. Notes.
Yeah, biography should be there. His name is Kyle O'Shea.
Kyle O'Shea?
And he kind of replies and goes, well, look, if it makes you feel any better, my granddad's name was Shea.
You wouldn't happen to have, like, a brilliant rapier at his side or anything?
No.
Sure?
I'm sure.
Kyle O'Shea.
You have a black scarf? Does he love his grandfather a lot?
Yeah. And fake alias of high class Ariel. There we go.
Okay.
We've got it all noted down.
No. That the guy we got kicked off the membership, you'd have to ask for my manager, or I can have it ask for you if you like. But no, he was some sort of alchemist. I'm not sure actually how he got his membership here, but had the whole, as soon as he got angry, his hair all flared up in a fire. It was frightening.
Matt?
Yep.
That seems descriptive enough that I can make a society check on it.
You can give it a shot. It's going to be extremely hot, though.
Yeah. No, it's not, Matt. What do you mean? I know this guy. We were kids together.
You went to cleric college together. Wait, wrong character.
You don't remember me, do you?
Oh, God. Well. It does
all
actually ring a bell.
Rolls, but no.
It does actually ring a bell. Because there was a, Alkenstar is pretty not restrictive, but when it comes to the worshiping of gods, there's so much technology in the city that they don't have much truck for religious factions in the slightest.
I would know that, being a member of a religious faction.
It's not to say that they're antagonistic against any of them, but it's just not something that's really trendy in the city, as you would have it in some place like Absalom, where the Starstone is around.
Yeah. Or, as a note, Kaer Maga. That's just a fun little piece of Pathfinder lore for you guys. They've got a whole street with a bunch of shrines. A fun fact.
But you do know of a Shoma Lyserius. He was trying to petition at around the same time that you were for some official recognition by the city. Unfortunately, however, as a worshipper of
Norgober.
The city was less than happy to give him any funds for his worshipping.
Iconic. And he practices alchemy and has flaming hair?
Yep.
Alchemist.
How does one achieve flaming hair?
Yeah, do I know why he has flaming hair?
From your natural 20, you would know him as an Ifrit.
Oh, damn it.
Ifrit. I don't know. Not as hot as Ridge.
The Ridge.
I've heard tales.
We've all heard tales of Ridge. One day he will perform an Alkenstar. One day.
That's the epilogue.
Ridge goes on tour. But yes, you're not sure of an address or anything like that, but you do know of him as a alchemist. He has a particular obsession with explosives.
Connected to Powderkeg punks? Question mark?
Maybe.
I'm writing notes now, Matt. I feel so responsible.
Alright. Look at you being a great player. With that, however, I think we might go to a break.
Alright.
And I'm gonna check to see how my modem's going, but I think it's stable again.
It feels stable.
It looks stable. But yes, we'll be back in about 10 minutes. I might throw up a poll or something. But we hope to see you back then. We will be continuing our adventures in the Outlaws of Alkenstar.
Mm.
Yay!
And we are back! After our break, I have another coffee, which I probably shouldn't have, but fuck it. I'm tired. But what else is new?
Fried chicken.
Fried chicken is new?
I'm a little bit jealous. I really do for a fried chicken right now. But I am the broke, and it is fine.
Yeah, but you're going to PAX, sir.
Yes, I am going to PAX Unplug, and I'm pretty excited about that. And I'm staying with friends as well, so I don't have to pay for accommodation.
Wait, I'm not going.
That's nice.
Are you going there?
What? No.
You said Matt could have friends other than us.
Oh, he doesn't. Don't worry.
Good to know I'm not allowed to be Matt's friend.
Are you going?
I'm not. Where even is PAX Unplugged in? It's in the US, right?
Yeah, it's in Philadelphia.
Oh, never mind.
It's in good old Philly. Yeah.
The city of brotherly love?
The city of gritty. Everything else can go fuck itself.
The city of brotherly love?
Is that why it's called Philadelphia?
That is what Philadelphia means.
Oh, okay. Well, you learned some
cream cheese.
It is a cream cheese.
Oh, I don't like it now.
City of cheese.
No, the city of brotherly love and cream cheese. These two are not related.
I hope not.
That's what they tell you, at least.
So this is getting worse. So we lost, we left our heroes. Fragile, you're getting coffee and donuts with a pair of shield marshals who totally aren't cops.
Yeah.
They're very touchy about the fact they aren't cops, which I makes me they're think they're cops.
Private military hired by the council.
Well, the shield marshals occupy an interesting position within the city. They're law enforcement, but also not quite, and they're not quite a garrison either. But they are the closest thing Alkenstar has to a garrison or an internal police force.
Constabulary.
Yes. But the name kind of dates back before the invention of firearms within the area, or the introduction of firearms in the area, from when they were the shield of the people.
Probably before Lovelace, then, too.
Very much before she rose through the ranks. And as far as you're aware, Lovelace runs the shield marshals in Smokeside.
Oh, she doesn't even run both of the both parts? Wild. I thought she was, like, head of the whole operation, the whole kit and caboodle.
Well, there is some argument to that fact. Officially, she's only in charge of Smokeside. But considering the position of Shield Marshal within Skyside, especially anything to do with leadership, is considered a more of a cushy job.
Yeah, because we don't do crimes. Because financial crimes haven't been invented yet.
Oh, I'm sure they have. It's just people don't get arrested for it.
Yeah, because they aren't violent crimes.
Financial crimes are as old as Abadar.
How does Abadar feel about financial crimes, actually?
Probably he's not very good.
Bad?
He's bad. Neutral, though.
Yeah, but no, financial crimes are, you're not obeying the law, because it's a crime.
Okay, but what if you're technically within the law?
Oh, then that's fine.
Yeah.
That's not a financial crime, though.
Like, it's okay if you rip off hundreds of thousands of people, as long as it's legal.
Yeah.
God, I hate Abadar. At least the prophets of Palestrade are honest about their, you know, scumbaggery.
Abadar brings order.
Nick, you're not going to say anything in defense of the prophets of Calistrate?
I don't need to, Matthew. The prophets are all they need.
The prophets defend themselves.
Next thing you know, I find out my account's been emptied of all of its resources.
And good luck getting the PAX unplugged now, Matt.
Tickets are already paid for. The count stop me now. But, Fragile, were there any questions for the shield marshals while you're having coffee and donuts with them? The more angry one has chilled out considerably over his second or third donut.
Then what's the deal with that Lovelace?
Lovelace?
You know, the elf lady.
Oh, Lovelace. Oh, I mean, she's fine. She's boss. She's our commanding officer.
They don't take the opportunity to shit talk their boss every chance they get. Wild.
Give me a diplomacy check, Fragile.
Fragile's good at those.
Is it Fragile or is it Nick?
Nick.
Bit of column A, bit of column B. Oh, look, she's fine. Yeah, she's a bit rough around the edges, but...
Yeah, no, she, like, shot me twice.
I'm sorry, God. What? She...
No. Gosh. Darn it. I knew it was coming, but it kills me every time.
I'm sorry. Ma'am, she shot you?
I know, right? How rude.
Were you on the run?
No, I was on some kind of bike. The second time, anyway, I was on a bike.
You were on a velocipede?
Yeah.
I'm so confused, ma'am.
First time was out in the desert.
Oh my god.
She don't have any jurisdiction out in the desert, though. What are you talking about, ma'am? You're gonna have to explain yourself a little bit. We're talking Angelique Loveless, right?
Yeah.
Commander of the shield marshals for Smokeside.
Now you remember her full name.
Owes me two apologies.
Two? Now, I think you're going to have to explain yourself a little bit more there. The other one's just kind of casually sipping his coffee.
Can't wait to bail Fragile out of jail. By bail, I mean break her out of, by saying there's been an emergency prisoner transfer.
Do I have, like, a prison map standing by? I'm pretty sure I can get one pretty quickly. So, you ain't no criminal, are you? You're too pretty.
Well, I don't look like a criminal, do I? I'm a mercenary.
So why would she be shooting a mercenary like you? Especially one as pretty.
Jealousy?
Jealousy. That was about right. Turning saints into... I mean, her name is Loveless, so...
I mean, she's still allowed to love.
I would say her name would disagree with you, Matt.
A little bit less than. Well, so you were out in the desert and she shot you.
Yeah, she shot a guy and then she shot me. Okay. I was supposed to shoot the guy, but that turned out to be a lie. I know, right? Isn't that amazing?
Well, what do you mean shooting him was a lie?
So I'm a mercenary, right?
Yep, no, we got that part.
No, and I'm, like, really good.
Okay.
But, it was a setup, can you believe it?
You were set up.
Yeah! I was hired to go shoot a guy, but it turned out that I wasn't supposed to shoot the guy. And so she shot the guy, and then she shot me. Oh god, the stupidity's catching in my throat.
He's broken character.
Every so I have time.
And okay. Then the next time? Yeah. The next time, yeah. It was midnight, so all the robots stopped working. And then we jumped out of the window and onto some velocipedes, and she shot me again.
This is when she shot you in the back.
Yeah!
And I'm surprised. You're not one of them. You're not undead or anything, are you? You look mighty real.
She, like, pinches herself. No, no.
Yeah, no, because it's not often she leaves people standing.
Oh, no, I almost died.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Massive damage would like to have us talk to you.
I don't use massive damage rules. We've been over this.
I'll be honest, massive damage only comes into effect, like, once in a blue moon, and that was it.
I think that I've had two instances of recently where massive damage would have come into play.
So she looks around all conspiratorially, and then, like, leans in real close. So don't tell anyone, but I am on the lookout for her. I'm gonna get those apologies. So... if she ever asks about the person she shot behind a bank after robbing the bank and getting away on velocipedes...
goodness.
Don't tell her it was me! And then she taps the side of her nose.
Oh, okay. He's only half paying attention to what you're saying. Because you kind of lean in close, and he's trying his hardest to keep eye contact. But it's not really working. And he's also just kind of trying to subtly, like, smell you, because you have the perfume from the bathhouse still.
God bless the girl's day.
Give me a diplomacy check. Diplomacy or deception?
Not good at deception. Fragile never tells a lie.
Fragile's a very earnest person. Unlike Ariel, Ariel lies all the time.
I like that we're using, like, jellos and flan and pudding.
I could use a more accurate gift, but
please
that,
don't.
That'd probably be ban-worthy.
He only half absorbed what you had to say. And he's like, no, you know, if I ever get the chance to talk to Commander Lovelace, I will let her know.
No, don't let her know.
Oh, okay. No, I won't tell her that I met you.
You're so sweet. I like you.
This is probably lost on Fragile, but for everyone else, the toad he's kind of putting across is that of which he would be talking to a child.
Fair.
Just
I'm
vaguely...
so glad I didn't have to bail Fragile out of prison.
Vaguely condescending would be one way to put it. But he goes, so, what was your name?
I'm Fragile. Fragile the Fox.
Oh, dang it. Fragile's not wearing her not fragile shirt.
Oh, no, she is.
Oh, she is.
Okay.
You see his eyes. Yeah, you see his eyes dot down to your shirt for a couple of moments and goes, okay, that's a little bit weird. So what are you doing later?
Yeah.
You know, I get off shift in a couple of hours.
Oh, okay.
I'm pretty sure I could convince Henry here to find someone to replace me. And, you know...
Yeah?
I think I'm coming down with something.
Oh, I wouldn't want you to come down with anything.
Well, I'm sure we can figure out something I can come down with.
Sure, well, if you're feeling up to it, I'll be at the Barrel and Bullet Saloon probably later.
Okay.
Fuck. Fucking hell.
No!
That's where all my friends go.
Oh, well, that's very interesting. And I suppose we would be still able to have a little bit of a private conversation if we needed to.
Oh, absolutely. You could come up to my room.
He is having trouble keeping his composure. Poor Tonk, yes. He's having trouble keeping his composure.
Ah, his pants tighter.
To put it lightly, yes. Well, I will definitely be looking you up later, Miss Fragile. And you have been a delightful company.
I have.
He kind of goes to give you a hug, but then kind of thinks better of it and goes to shake your hand instead.
I pull him in and give him, like, a kiss on the cheek. You are cute.
He kind of goes, aw, shucks, man. I better get back on patrol, though. Thank you for the coffee.
Anytime.
Completely ignoring the fact that he paid for the coffees and for the donuts.
Hell yeah, he did.
Yeah. And he kind of wanders off, and, you know, his offsider is giving him the third degree for getting taken in by a young lady.
We lost him.
Ugh. Fragile gets free food.
I mean, you would have got it. Well, actually, no, you're kind of broke, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, no. Kyle is more than happy to pay for your dinner.
Exactly.
He will put it on his
tab. Even broke.
I know she's not. But no. He will absolutely order dinner for the two of you, and you will have a lovely night with him.
Iconic.
He's very much Kansas, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Very big, very strong, heart of gold.
Himbo energy, that's what I'm hearing.
We'll go with that. But otherwise, eventually, it comes to the end of the night, and you have your final drinks, and he goes, well, Miss Farmhand.
Aye?
Thank you for the pleasure of your company.
I will thank you for the pleasure of your company.
And next time I'm having a match, is there some place I can have you looked up? Make sure some tickets get thrown your way?
Yeah,
it's just going to be the one ticket, right?
I am absolutely a dandy, and I would know how to have a fake address.
Yep.
That would look proper. And I would give him that address.
Oh, okay.
That I still get mail from, though.
Because you're a dandy, right?
Because I'm a dandy.
And you can...
they give you so much for this archetype, apparently, now.
So much. Is this because, despite never having used any of the actions from the archetype, Ridge has gotten so much work out of celebrity?
No, this was just because you let me into the bar without making any checks because I was a dandy, and I'm living for it.
No, look, I will grab the screenshot of the journal entry, and I will post it on Twitter and Discord and everything. It is literally in there.
I don't doubt you for a second. But also, I really don't want to give him my real address, because as much as Fragile is comfortable inviting random people to the Bullet and Barrel Saloon, I don't think Adeline would have an address at the Bullet and Barrel Saloon. Considering it's, you know, in Smokeside.
You give him the first Skyside address that comes to mind.
Mm-hmm.
That would be the address of Vashon Gattleby.
God damn it! I knew you were gonna say that! That's my fake address. I live there now.
You just casually live there. Well, it's not like Vashon's living there.
Exactly.
And the traps have been disabled, so you know it's fine, right?
I'm squatting.
But you give him the address and he goes, well, I'll make sure that next time I'm going to be out on the field, I'll make sure that you get some tickets.
Aye, and I very much appreciate that.
You wouldn't be needing a plus one ticket now, would you?
I know. It's just me.
Well, there's nothing wrong with it being just you. And he gives you a very chaste kiss upon the hand.
Wow.
Coward.
So Fragile, just fucking coward. How fucking sweet of him.
He's a country boy. He's not gonna give you a full kiss on the first date.
Oh, no, absolutely not.
No.
Ariel understands that. Fragile wouldn't, but Ariel does. she will sort of like curtsy.
Yep.
And bid him good night.
All right. Well, eventually everyone is going to recollect back at the Bullet and Barrel. Unless you had other things you wanted to do, Sam.
I would have been spending a day's worth of downtime crafting.
Yep, which is fine and easy to do. As we did for last time, if you want to get on a call or something later and we can go through all the stuff that you do during downtime.
I'll just roll the dice now.
Yep. Beautiful!
I think that's a critical success for a pepper box.
By level, yes it is.
Neato. Okay.
Because the DC is like 16 for level 1.
I probably should have told you how much I was spending.
All of it? Most of it.
No, I was spending 1.6, which is half of what I can spend for a day's worth of work. Ah. And because it's critical success, I get my hyper focus bonus. So I get 4 GP worth of project values, 12.
Nice.
So I've only got 5.1 GP worth to do.
So another day or two and you should be fine?
Huh? Another day.
Alright. Well, Hinkle.
Yeah.
Eventually the two girls will come back from their spa day. Tonk hasn't returned yet.
Tonk's dead. Yeah, and like, I have killed him.
Should we be worried about Tonk, or is this just like, just because Ian's not here?
His gravity weapon pulled him into an abyss that he's now unable to get out of.
I will talk to Ian at some point during the week and ask him what Tonk was up to, because I know what he was doing last time.
He can always help me craft.
He could probably help you craft, but I know he was staking out a location that was known to the Powderkeg Punks. So there might be some drama that ensues from that. But like I said, I will talk to Ian during the week and we will work that out. But, Hinkle, the two girls will eventually return. It's a little bit further in the evening, perhaps 8 o'clock-ish.
Needy.
And the three of you can get together and discuss the things you all found out during the day.
There seems to be this suspicious character that the Powderkeg punks are associating with, named Shoma Lysarius. He's a worshipper of Norgabert, sort of an alchemist, he's an ifrit, and there seems to be some connection between him and the Powderkeg punks, which seems to make me think that there's something more than just the Powderkeg punks going on, with their whole escapades.
Haven't an Orgabites been punched down a peg by some people in that star city?
Haven't they, Matt?
Give me a society check.
Can it be a religion check instead?
Yes.
Actually, I think they're about the same. Actually, society might be better. Society is better, amazingly enough. That's what expert gets you. So we will be making... Oh, it's a multiple of 5! I love multiples of 5.
So, what
Except
you know,
Except for 20.
Ariel.
That multiple's trash.
What you know, Ariel, is recently in Absalom, last summer, they had the Radiant Festival, which was supposed to be a big jubilee-like event to celebrate Absalom's perseverance before so many different conflicts and having to survive over and over again. Unfortunately, however, the Radiant Festival was interrupted when a group of individuals known as the Twilight Four tried to take over the city. Thankfully,
however...
Were
they stopped by the agents of Edgewatch?
They were, in fact, stopped by some Star Watch agents. The details of who was actually involved are a little bit fuzzy. But what is known... is that they were quite successful, and although Nolgabar was blamed for it, it turned out to be the ministrations of another god that was at play.
Neat.
That said, however...
Spoilers.
In slight spoilers, it's fine. But during the whole fallout of that, the Church of Norgabert made the decision to retreat back to their holy city of Nidel, or the country of Nidel. And as such, their activities have been lessened within the last 6 months or so.
But that didn't stop this alchemist guy.
It does, however, suggest that he might be working alone. And considering what you found out earlier, or... from what you remembered of your meeting him in passing, you get the feeling he doesn't have much in the way of followers, and he might just be in this himself.
Well, clearly not all by himself, because he's got some Powderkeg punk friends.
Followers are for schmucks, families forever.
What are you, Vin Diesel?
No, I am Hinkle Moon.
Which is German for Vin Diesel.
Look, I don't think that's correct, but I don't know enough German to be able to argue. But he was dressed rather well, from what you remember.
Of hearing about him? So he's sort of a fancier guy. Okay. Yeah.
Connected to some degree, but you're not sure what.
Yeah, I will... I would love to, when I get back, ask Vashon if he remembers anything. Vashon. If he knows anything about this guy, because they're both alchemists. Is that alchemist racist? Probably not.
Well, look. When you're enough of a professional and professionals know professionals.
Yep.
You get together, you talk, you share notes, you do all that other stuff. So you go and talk to Vashon about Shoma, and he kind of rolls his eyes and goes, yeah, what does the kid want now?
Well, it seems that he's been teaming up with the Powderkeg punks.
Yeah, right. Oh, you're serious?
I
took him for way too much of a fancy lad for that.
The boss was seen trying to get to him at the name of place I definitely remember.
Longhorn Lounge?
At the Longhorn Lounge.
Okay, so here's what I know about Shoma. A couple of years back, I did a guest lecture at one of the local colleges, Blath College. It was on alchemy and stuff like that, so it was well within my wheelhouse, and they were paying me a fair bit of money, so I figured, why the fuck not? But did the lecture, taught them a couple of things, gave them some life advice that I'm sure their parents would never allow them to have gotten. But once all was said and done, I had the dean come up to me and said, I'm going to introduce you to one of the students in the audience, because he would like to meet you. And I was like, fuck that noise. But he was like, no, this kid's got money. And I would like you to do this, and you'll get a cut of the money. So I was like, fine, we'll talk to the rich boy. And that was when I met Shuba.
And that's all you know about him?
Well, he spent a little bit of time barking up my tree. Trying to get more information, He wanted to be my apprentice. But I don't do that kind of thing.
Obviously that didn't happen.
Well, no, I don't do that kind of thing. My research is personal, and although I'm happy to help groups of people from time to time, taking on a singular individual is more effort than I would like. But the kid's rich. I probably took a little bit too much of his money. But in my defense, he took up a little bit too much of my time. But, what? Not too long ago, a couple of weeks, a couple of months, just upped and disappeared. He was invited to the demonstration. Not sure whether he turned up or not.
You wouldn't know what he'd want with the punks, then? Probably not, then.
I wouldn't know myself. I would know that he is not a... I don't think he would have it in him to be a... card-carrying member of any gang.
Aye, well. Thank you for your assistance.
Hey, you're welcome, Miss Smithfield.
Well, that went a place. Was that place nowhere? I wouldn't go that far. But it went a place.
Well... What do you know about him? Break it down.
He seems to be an Ifrit alchemist, follower of Norgabar.
Yep.
With flaming hair, and connected to Powderkeg punks, ? Very rich. I need to add that to my notes.
Is Shuma the Ifrit, or is the guy going, the Powderkeg punks boss the Ifrit?
Shumer's the Ifrit. Right, Matt?
Yep.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, Ariel was not diplomatic enough to get the extra information about the Powderkeg punks.
Well, listen, I can only roll well so often, Matt.
I know, I'm not holding it against you. But, Fragile.
Eh?
Are you going to pass on some of your information to the rest of the group as well?
Oh, sure. So there's this gnome over in the Iron Quarter, and he hypnotizes the punks, and the punks do the bad things, and somehow Lovelace is involved, and she's over in Iron Quarter, and the cop's going to come and see me in my room.
I'm just going to ignore the last part of that, and... So,
this is a long combat episode by the looks of it. We'll see. The night's not done yet.
Yeah.
The night is but so young.
Hey, so there's a gnome that's,
Yeah, hypnotist.
Hypno gnome.
I wouldn't happen to know anything about hypno gnomes with my lore city.
Hypnome.
Give me a lore city. Please do not roll a one on this.
Listen, I try my best, Matt. That was pretty good.
21 is pretty good. Yes, chat, save your hero points unless you really want to give one to Ariel, because she's been rolling well.
Terribly.
Well, no, it alternates between good and really bad. And it's just like on the important ones, it tends to be bad.
You don't know of any hypnotizing gnome in the city of any real fame. The fact that a shield marshal might be coming by later to see Fragile is...
How also concerning.
It's a little concerning, but it's Fragile.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this isn't exactly a shield marshal bar, so...
What are the chances that he gets just... beat up as soon as he enters the door, Matt?
Well, I mean, if you want to discuss it with Phoebe.
I mean, I don't want him getting beat up. I specifically am trying to avoid that, because that seems like a confrontation that we wouldn't want to draw attention to our hiding place.
Yeah, no, you absolutely wouldn't.
I mean, it's more your hiding place. I basically hide in the shed out back building.
The workshop.
Fragile doesn't hide.
Fragile does not hide, and that is part of the problem.
So, connecting the dots from the other things that Fragile said, you can probably, you know, dismiss the whole Lovelace thing.
The gnome?
The gnome hypnotist is probably a little bit off. Otherwise, considering Fragile and her notorious attention span, shall we say?
Yeah.
At the very least, the shield marshal might be able to be pumped for information as well.
Fair enough.
And sure enough...
The pair of you can interrogate him together.
Well, I mean, you absolutely can do that as he enters the bar. Also, Ariel, you have been given a hero point by chat.
Aw, thank you, chat. Matt, I want it noted, I have shown my face to this guard before.
Yes, you have.
What are the odds he recognizes me?
It depends on how much of a show you make of your appearance.
I feel like in the disguise as a shield marshal, she would have appeared pretty, I mean, you know, fairly attractive, but not sort of dressed up rather plainly, whereas
yeah.
Currently she is dressed to the nines. and so, you know.
He will enter. Still in his uniform, but he's kind of got an overcoat.
Also not wearing a uniform of his boss.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
So.
So he's still in vaguely in uniform, but like I said, he's got an overcoat over the top of it. So he's a little bit more casual, and he's trying not to broadcast that he's a shield marshal. But considering the clientele of the Bullet and Barrel Saloon, he is absolutely picked out as a shield marshal from the first steps he takes in there.
Can I sort of give, like, a everybody take, like, two steps?
Everyone chill?
Everyone chill, look.
I want to say diplomacy.
Okay. I can try.
And Fragile, what are you doing as he walks in? You do have a hero point.
See if I need it. Nah, that's good enough for everybody. Chill.
That's good enough? Alright. Fragile, what are you doing as he walks in?
So Fragile's probably got bored when Ariel walked away and, like, just, like, casually puts the barrel of her gun in her mouth, just like, meow. Anyway. When she sees him, she, like, takes it out, then sort of bunny hops over to him.
I'm so glad you came!
Oh, Miss Fragile.
That's what she said.
I honestly was half expecting you not to be here. I'm glad to see you, though.
Me too.
I should buy you a drink.
You should.
Takes him over to the bar.
Yep.
Almost pulls his arm straight off.
Phoebe makes a big show of pouring him a drink. Doesn't even ask for money first. If everyone wants to make a perception check, they absolutely can.
Yeah, I can. We'll see how well my everyone chill look has... Oh, sorry, I've rolled that publicly. Apologies.
That's all good.
Do you want me to re-roll it privately, or...?
No, that should be fine.
Alright.
Because, Hinkle, you also see this as Fragile is doing very well to distract our shield marshal friend. And Phoebe is taking the stronger alcohol. It's not good stuff, but the idea is to get him as drunk as possible as quickly as possible.
Fair enough, honestly.
Hey, so listen, we were just talking about the hypno gnome.
The hypno gnome? Oh, yeah. The hippodrome.
Oh, wait! That slipped my mind entirely! I honestly thought there was a hypno gnome.
Oh, I definitely knew there was.
I win.
But I could not remember what the hypno gnome was a misnomer for.
No, look, if I didn't have the notes open in front of me right now, I probably would have had trouble with it as well. So you're fine. Because that word soup was a saccharine mess, and holy hell. But Phoebe pours him a drink and then pours you a different drink, Fragile, and the two of you can start drinking. And he's like, yeah, no, the hippodrome. You didn't go past there, did you?
No, that's like all the way over there.
Yeah.
How do we get there?
What? You mean over an iron, like the Ironside Quarter?
Yeah.
Matt, I'm obviously reading the lips of this conversation.
They're not being quiet about it either.
I would absolutely love to roll Lore City about the Hippodrome.
Yep, in the Ironside Quarter.
In the Ironside Quarter. 22?
He's probably referring to the Hotfoot Hippodrome. It's more of a recent place. It's known as something of an underground club for, well, goblin metal music. Which is not to everyone's taste.
Hippodrome.
Yeah, Chat gives you a hero point, and you're not going to end up needing it.
Metal music. Well, I'm sorry that now my luck turns, okay?
But you know it as a, it's a dance hall and a music club. They have a cover fee. It's not that they're exclusive, it's just a means to make money. No one's quite sure of who owns them, or at least your check's not good enough to know who owns the place. But considering the other information that's been gathered, you could probably put two and two together.
Okay. I want it noted, I put it in my notes. Hotfoot Hippodrome. Goblin metal music. Are the powder keg punks there? Who knows?
But he goes, yeah, no, I mean, if you want to go somewhere else, Fragile, I mean, there's probably somewhere better we could go.
I'm offended for Phoebe.
What do you mean?
Well, we don't have, the Hippodrome's not exactly a great place. I mean, we don't have to go there. We could just stay here. I mean,
you asking me on a date to the Hippodrome? I'd love to see metal goblins. I've only seen metal guys like that one over there. He's my best friend. I pointed the robot. I forgot the name. Sorry. Heinrich?
Hey. He's literally on the character.
I can't see it.
Hover over him!
Now I can.
There you go.
He's secret.
Yeah. Our shield marshal friend looks over and goes, yeah, okay. Give me a diplomacy check, Fragile.
You got it. Ooh.
Well, I mean, it's not exactly...
I could lend the hero point, Fragile, if you want it.
Are you going to take it on the chin?
Yeah, because I'm going to up the ante.
Oh, God, okay. He's like, well, look.
When I see him start to struggle, just, I'll let you see my tits.
Oh, my God!
He chokes on his drink a little bit. As you say that, he's trying to hide his stammering behind the drink. And it's not really working now. As there is a little bit of a spray. And he goes, you did mention something about going up to your room.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned something about taking me out to the Hippodrome.
With two fingers, she just starts walking up his arm.
At this point, he is a blushing, stammering mess.
Ha, nerd.
I must admit, I haven't met anyone as forward as you, Fragile.
I bet they have all sorts of heavy metals over there. I bet it's real hot.
Phoebe, as subtle as you like, has already managed to put a new drink in his hand as he kind of downs it in one gulp. And there's a bit of a coughing as he was not expecting the harsh alcohol to flow down his throat as he tries his best to swallow back and be a little bit more confident. And he kind of just, after taking a couple of breaths, he goes, well, how about we,
let's just go.
How about we go up to your room and get properly changed, and then we can probably go to the Hippodrome?
Dude, come on! Just one second.
He yells out,
hey guys, I'm going to the Hippodrome with my boyfriend. You guys should come.
I bet, double date. I feel, Our dear masseuse is so sad.
Ooh, that's actually a good question. Is he here at the moment, or is he working late at the bathhouse?
hey, my dude, do you really think Fragile doesn't refer to literally everyone as her boyfriend?
Oh no,
yeah,
I get that.
But he doesn't know that.
He's been near her like a couple days now.
Yeah, no, that's true. So, he is currently not there. I flipped a card, and it... Yes.
Flipped a card?
Yeah, I flipped a card. I have a deck of cards that I have sitting beside my computer for whenever I need to make decisions like that on the fly.
They usually don't work out in my favor. I don't like the cards.
Fate is not in your cards.
Ariel and Tinkle, from your perception checks, it's kind of easy to notice that several members or several of the residents in the bar have made note of this.
Are they going to jump him?
You're not sure, because it would absolutely change depending on who you talk to. You do, however, know that some of the patrons are very protective of her.
I sort of motion that I'm definitely going with Fragile.
I guess we're now watching Comey overly communicates.
I would love to have whatever Phoebe was given that guard.
As just I actually load up the bull and barrel.
Just a hit off of that.
Just a quick hit, so you can kind of...
Just a quick shot. You want me to make a fort save, Matt?
Yeah, I'll get a fort save from here.
Ariel. Fortitude save. Yeah.
Yeah, nope, you're good.
Five.
You're absolutely fine. It's strong. Like, this is a step or two up from moonshine.
It's just ever clear.
Oh, there's Tonk. I found him.
He's probably in the saloon. Where's Lady Grieve? Lady Grieve is also here, but...
The fuck is Lady Grieve?
I believe that is our... one of the people we know.
Patrons. There she is. Lady Grieve. She's a leshy. And is not involved in organized crime whatsoever.
Oh, okay. The con one. The con artist. And she's chill.
So. Fragile. The two of you will be going up to your room?
Yep.
Alright.
Yep.
Ariel will be following upstairs, not necessarily to Fragile's room. But definitely to her room, which happens to be right next to Fragile's room.
Okay. And do you make a big show of kind of going into the room next to her?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want anyone creating a stir, as it were.
Hinkle.
Yeah.
Down in the bar, people are taking bets.
How long he survives.
No, whether he survives, and in what state does he leave?
Contented, I believe, is probably his outcome.
Well, no, there's actually a couple of people who are placing bets that he'll, like, go running out a little bit too blushy.
Oh.
Like, he just can't take it and just chickens out and runs.
Sensory overload.
Yeah, because Fragile can be a little bit too much.
I'm going to go with the sensory overload.
There are a couple of people who are suggesting he's not going to make it through the night.
Oh, they're silly.
Because
he'll be fine unless Ariel steps in. If additional people enter that room, then whether or not he makes it out of the room is definitely up for debate there.
I'll be honest, It's not Ariel I'm worried about. It's if Tonk comes home.
He's there by the stairs.
He is currently there by the stairs, but as I said, I will talk to Ian and find out what he wants done with Tonk. Now, Fragile. Because we can't go into too many details for obvious reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Tell that to Shy Lily.
Womp womp. What kind of happens while the two of you are up there?
Well, the second, like, the door closes, Fragile is undressing.
Yep.
He has no shame. And she's, like, picking out a cute outfit to go out tonight in.
Well, he is stammering an awful lot as you do this.
What's up?
You have... Fragile, you're naked.
Yes. Do you have something to wear?
I guess I could take my uniform off. Is that what's happening here?
Is it? I thought we were getting changed to go out tonight.
Yeah, no, I thought I was just going to be seeing... I didn't think I'd be...
You've seen a girl naked before, right?
He makes a will save.
Ooh.
Ooh.
I've seen plenty of girls before. Absolutely. Yep, I know exactly how a woman looks like without her clothes on. Absolutely.
I do believe that would be against Fragile's perception, DC.
Oh no, this is to see whether he has the mental fortitude to actually stay in the room.
No, I was saying his obvious lie.
Ah.
Fragile's not bright.
Well, he doesn't really have much skill in deception either. He's being awful shy, though. And it wouldn't be the first time you've had a guy collapse on you, Fragile.
Oh, like, on me? On me?
Just kind of like flake. He looks skittish. So, what outfit are you picking out?
I think shorts, short top combo.
Yep.
Thigh highs.
Yep.
Absolutely territorial.
Maybe like some arm warmers.
Yep.
What colors?
Like, I like the classic black and white stripes.
Oh, I thought you were going full neon for the hippo gnome.
The hippodrome.
Hippo gnome.
The hypno gnome.
You don't think the hypno gnome like sees in movement, do you? Should I wear something camo? I don't want him to hypnotize me.
I don't think they do that there, Miss Fragile.
My brain is big and smart.
I will take your word for that one, Miss Fragile. At this point, he has taken off his uniform, like his uniform shirt, and he's down to his like trousers and his singlet. As he makes another will save.
Oh, that's better.
He is managing to stay in the room and has not run out as yet. You finish getting dressed, and
he's
got
frightened three though.
I have some stuff that might fit you. If you want to try it,
I mean,
are you just gonna give him Tonk's clothes?
Nah, I'm gonna see if he's up for like some cross dressing.
Oh.
Okay.
I should make another will save.
I think you'd look good in this. And she hands him, like, it's a modest skirt.
Well, Fragile owns a modest skirt.
now.
No, I think
he's doing great.
I think my trousers will be just fine, Miss Fragile. But I don't know, they're appreciate looking kinda tight. Oh, they're usually not this tight. I can tell you that now.
Get my pants.
I might just wait outside while you finish getting dressed.
Oh, I'm almost done. Don't worry.
Oh, okay. Another minute or two passes, and you catch him stealing looks whenever he can. But eventually you finish getting dressed, and he looks reasonable. You can tell, though, he wasn't expected to be going out on a date tonight. But he will absolutely take it either way.
Yeah, he will.
But once you finish getting dressed, you take him out, I'm guessing?
Yep.
For you, Ariel.
Yeah?
Things inside seem to have gone pretty fine.
Alright. They seem to have gone pretty well.
No one comes up the stairs to have a look. Doesn't look like anyone's going to be jumping him in anytime soon.
That's good.
Also, no loud noises.
That's also good.
Depending on your point of view.
Just a lot of vibration.
Eventually, however, you do hear the two of them leave the room.
Yeah, I would follow. And I absolutely am going to go down to the bar and find the nearest available bachelor or bachelorette who looks like they would be very easily convinced on going on a double date with me and Fragile.
Or who are you asking?
Matt, I gave you the description.
Is that my guy?
That's your guy. That is the default outwork for one of our shield marshals.
No, I could bend him up.
Yeah. God.
I would first be looking, presumably, for the Ooh. Perfect candidate, so I should probably make a perception check.
You absolutely
for
should.
That, Matt. God darn it. I hate perception checks.
Why? Because they're secret?
Yes!
Well, as you're kind of looking around the bar to grab someone, Lady Grieve takes a hold of her bodyguard, or her off-sider, and goes, "Hey, Ariel, you're going with Fragile, aren't you?"
Yes, I am.
Why don't you take Liam here with you?
I will, Liam. Aren't you ready for a night of right entertainment? And I will take him arm in arm and begin walking after Fragile, who I presume is a little bit ahead of me.
A little bit ahead of you, yes. Hinkle, are you going to follow them as well?
Fuck no, I hate goblin cacophony.
Easy done. And I will figure out what Tonk will be doing. But we can do that a little bit off screen a little bit later. The walk to the Hippodrome itself, it takes a good half an hour, just kind of walking through the city. But our shield marshal friend, he's pretty good and knows the directions, especially for the local area. And at some point, we will have to name this guy. Because I'm not sure if we've actually asked his name yet or not.
Fragile absolutely has not.
Yeah.
And will she is another matter entirely.
Also no.
Doesn't matter, it's fine.
Let me put down Liam in my notes. Gotta keep all their names straight, man.
Alright. I'm gonna go with Gary for now. Cause I'm pretty
Slay
sure we
laid a punk.
Cause I'm pretty sure we've already used Stanley somewhere.
Stanley's the one that gets kidnapped.
Yes. Our poor kidnapping victim. But eventually you do get to the Hot Foot Hippodrome, and by this time in the evening, it's actually a buzz of activity. there is a lineup and everything, and it's going halfway around the warehouse-like building. It's one of those retrofits that's happened in the Ironside Quarter, where the place has recently been visited by some devastation and has been cut off for the most part by the rest of the city. However, there are some reconstruction efforts happening, but they're more on the slumlord type of reconstruction. And you can line up if you like, or you can try to skip the line. It is up to you.
Matt, how well does it look like they would just let a dandy right in there?
No, this is not high class enough for a dandy, I'm afraid.
I know.
So.
Well, I will do what Fragile does, so. I'm following Fragile's lead.
So, Fragile, what are you doing?
We're just walking in.
The bouncer, as you kind of come up the line, gives you the once over and kind of nods, but he puts his hand on the chest of your suitor, Gary. And the bouncer goes, nah. Look, she can go in, but we're full up otherwise.
Hey, if I may, sir, they are sort of a package deal. It's not like you're gonna be able to have one without the other, and I would just please humor her. She's a little bit on the more eccentric side, but you know, I would say it would be in your best interest to humor her.
It does look like she's a bit on the crazy hard scale. Give me a deception check, Ariel.
Oh, I love those.
You love those?
Good at those. I am good at those. Look at that. Who needs a hero point?
He looks to you, Ariel, and he looks to Liam. And he goes, okay. Don't be any trouble in there, yeah?
We shan't be. And so we're in. Let's go.
And as I switch it to nighttime,
with our we're in. Unfortunately, missing our dear inventor friend.
You are missing your dear inventor friend.
I'm sad. I bet he'd love the metal goblins.
He absolutely would not.
Yeah. No. Look. Soon as the door opens. Like, you have a little bit of an entryway, a hallway that's got some people in there who are just kind of mingling, having a couple of quiet drinks. But there is definitely the thumping of noise that's happening through the thick walls of this place. Ariel, you know heavy, like, thick metal when it's being put on walls. Someone has actually gone to the effort of shielding this hallway as much as possible and soundproofing it.
Nice. And it's still making it through.
And there is a vibration that's going through the concrete flooring as well. And there are the signs of cracks where it's gone a little bit too far.
Hey, Liam, just prepare yourself.
He nods and goes, this is not the first time I've been here.
Aye, fair enough. Right, good lad.
So, when does the gnome come out?
Gary's
are we going
looking
into the main portion.
Well, what? That's kind of up to you. You're
again,
looking for more information, but you're following.
I'm following Fragile.
Yeah. Gary is looking increasingly nervous, like a fish out of water. He knows he doesn't belong here. And even as he kind of makes his way through on your arm, Fragile, there is a lot of people who are just making eyes at him as he goes in. And they're not friendly looks. Fragile may be oblivious to this, but Ariel, you are not.
I am walking alongside them, and I'm just like, at this point, I'm like, don't worry. Just don't do anything, that might spook anybody, and you'll be fine. Is there a check to moralize people? I don't want to demoralize him. I want to moralize him.
What is the opposite of a demoralize? Diplomacy. Ouch.
Okay, I will roll diplomacy.
If you're trying to make sure he doesn't...
Who needs a hero point?
He kind of takes a deep breath and he's like, "Yeah, no, it's fine. No one knows who I am here. This will be fine."
They don't know that you're a cop?
Oh my god.
As you get through closer to the end of the hallway, there is a section for checking your weapons.
I was about to be like, could I like ruffle his hair or something to make him look more like he fits here? But then I realized that is in fact a skill feat.
That is in fact a skill feat.
Yeah.
Does everyone check their weapons?
I do not have it. Ariel would have brought hers, actually. She would have. And she will check it.
Fragile would have brought hers and just keeps on walking.
Ma'am, you need to check your rifle.
That's not a replica. It's not a real one.
It is pink and bedazzled.
I know it's pink and bedazzled.
You want me to roll deception, Ma'am?
Abso-fucking-lutely.
What? Clearly, just having a hero point is all I need.
Apparently. Fucking, yeah, alright, whatever.
throwing out so many deception checks this round.
The person behind the counter kind of has a look at this pink and bedazzled rifle. And there's a couple of moments of calculation that happens, and then kind of looks at Fragile's attire. And there's some quick mental mathematics that happens in his head, and he goes, "Okay, so she's part of the floor show?" Alright, cool.
Not sure.
Like, you know there's like a staff entrance. You know what, whatever, just... make your way backstairs. I'm pretty sure one of the cages is empty at the moment.
Alright. I think I just signed up Fragile to be a stripper.
He's a go-go dancer.
Yeah, go-go dancer. Jeez.
The stripping will happen anyway.
To be fair, depending on the go-go dancer, some of them can be far more entertaining than the stripper.
That is also very true. But... as for the rest of you,
probably am not wearing my armor.
It gets to Gary, and he has to check his sidearm. And he tries to do so as subtly as possible. But give me a perception check, Ariel.
Yep, I can throw you a perception check, Matt. I'm not very good at them. If only I knew if I needed to use my hero point or not.
Oh no, you're good. You see him, he's trying, as I said, trying as subtle as possible to kind of slide his pistol, doing his best to cover the handle, the hilt of his pistol. Mm-hmm. But eventually the check clerk has to, you know, takes it from him. And that is when you see the Shield Marshal insignia on the firearm. And that's where I'm going to leave the session, as everyone kind of turns and looks, and the check clerk also starts giving everyone the look.
I hope you realize I'm about to say it's stolen.
Well, we will see how that turns out next week, where we will continue our adventures in Outlaws of Alkenstar for Pathfinder 2nd Edition by Paizo Publishing, powered by Foundry VTT with music by Michael Gelfi and Sirenscape. I know tonight's episode wasn't really combat intensive, and there was we pretty much just did a bunch of downtime stuff, but if that last couple of moments is any indication, the action will absolutely be happening next week, where things will be getting thrown down in one way, shape, or another, and we hope to see you there.
Whoa, that's if Ariel can't bullshit her way out of this one.
Well, we'll see how you go with that, won't we? But until then, we hope to see you next week at 6:30 Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time. We will be continuing. Hope you have a good day, a good night, a good week, no matter where you are in the world. We'll attempt to raid someone. We'll see who's available. I know PAX is currently going on, so we might just raid into PAX. But always remember, we are the storytellers. Goodbye.
Bye.